वेलकम टू माई पॉडकास्ट। टुडेज टॉपिक, स्पिरिचुअलिटी इज नॉट एन एस्केप। अ ग्रेट सेंट वॉज डाइंग एंड ऑल ऑफ हिज डिसिपल्स एंड डिवोटीज हैड गैदर्ड अराउंड हिम। हिज सक्सेसर वॉज स्टैंडिंग नियर हिज बेड। द सेंट सेड टू हिज सक्सेसर, रिमेंबर, नेवर अलाउ अ कैट इन योर लाइफ। एंड देन ही डाइड। The successor was a young man, and though in deep grief, he was puzzled by the last words of the saint. But an old man, who was also a disciple, but was not chosen as a successor because he was too old and was going to die within a year or two, said, "You don't know, there is a long story behind it. He has just given you the punchline." The successor said, "Then I must know the whole story." The story was about another saint. This saint had renounced his wife and children and his home and had went to the Himalayas, where he lived near a small village. That was where he got food to eat. The villagers were happy that they had a saint of their own, so they made a small bamboo cottage for him. The Indian monks, in place of an underwear, used a long strip of cotton cloth called langote. They were allowed to have only two langotis, but a trouble arose. Some rats came into the house and they started chewing on the langote. The man was in a great difficulty. He had only two langotis and soon they would be gone. So he asked the villagers what to do. "My sect does not allow a saint to have more than two langotis. That's the only possession allowed." The villagers said, "Why don't you take a cat from the village? She will kill the rats." It was a perfectly rational solution, so the villagers gave him a good cat, and the cat killed the rats. But the problem was, now he had to beg for his food. And now that the rats was finished, he had to beg for some milk for the cat too. The villager said, "This is a small village. The best thing for us is for you to have a cow. The whole village can contribute some money and purchase a beautiful cow. And in that way, you will become very independent. You can have enough milk for yourself and for your cat." It looked right. So a beautiful cow was brought in. Now the problem was that the cow needed grass. So every day he had to go to the village to beg for the grass. People said, "This does not look right. A great saint asking for grass? In fact, no saint has ever asked for grass. It is not conventional." The saint was worried and said, "What to do? My cat, my cow." So they said, "A simple solution we have. We are villagers. We don't know much about your philosophy. One woman has become a widow. Her husband has died and she has nobody. So we will persuade her. She will be really happy to serve a saint, and then you don't have to come to the village every day. We will clear some ground by the side of your hut so that she can grow grass and wheat, and she will take care of you in sickness." The idea was right. It was always right. It did not take a lot of effort to persuade the woman. She was alone and the saint was young. There was a possibility, a hope. So she immediately agreed. She started taking care of him, and things grew from there. The grass grows by itself. In fact, many things grow by themselves. So grass started growing. They fell in love. The woman was beautiful. The saint was young. What more was needed? They worked in the field and grew wheat grass. The cat was very happy and the cow was very happy and everything was perfect. But then they had children. And the saint thought, "My God, that's what I had left behind. And I had renounced the world. And now this is my whole world again. It grew so slowly that I was not aware until the children came. And so, the old man said, that was the punchline. He told you, remember not to allow a cat, because behind the cat, which is symbolic of your desire, or which represents desire, the whole world comes in. He was talking about his own life story, how he again became engaged in the same world, taking children to school and the routine life. And people started laughing at him. What kind of a saint are you? You are keeping a woman? You have fallen down from your greatness, they said. But what was he to do? He considered renouncing the world again, but he thought, what is the point? Those rats, meaning distractions, are everywhere. Again, the same story will start. It is better to be silent. Life is like an exam paper. Every moment it keeps testing your consciousness, and it always comes with two options, the consciousness and the unconsciousness. Consciousness means you are aware. Unconsciousness means you are living in utter ignorance. Just one mistake of choosing to be ignorant, of being unconscious, and the trouble starts all over again. You try to run away from the situation and you will end up facing the same situation elsewhere, because every other situation, every other moment will again test your consciousness, your awareness. Unless and until you learn to become conscious, to become aware, no matter how much you keep running away from situations, the end result will be the same. Just a missed consciousness, a missed awareness, and the saint found himself in the same situation that he had left behind. He had renounced this world, had left his wife and children, but ended up making a new family all over again. He tried to run away, but ended up with the same situation, because consciousness hadn't progressed. Awareness wasn't achieved in totality. And so the same mistake was repeated. The same situation was reborn. Rats are everywhere. Distractions are everywhere. Where will you go? What will you run away from? How do you run away from things that are in your head? Repeated breakups, repeated conflicts, repeated divorces are a result of running away from situations that demand your consciousness. And you will return to similar situations, seeking to repeat the same pattern in various ways again and again and again, until you stand up and learn to face the situation itself with a conscious mind. You cannot keep running away from your fears. At some point of life, you will have to build up the courage to face and overcome them. Life repeats itself mindlessly. Unless you become mindful and conscious, it will go on repeating like a wheel. Spirituality is not leaving your family, but modifying the definition of family in such a way that this whole world becomes your family, enabling you to experience that beautiful feeling of oneness. Running away from any problem only increases the distance from the solution. The only way to escape from the problem is to solve it. And so, never ever run away from any problem, face it and solve it, because that is the only way you can get over it. Meditate.